Hey everybody, welcome back to A Better Computer. My name is Matt, and today we're taking a look at Notion Calendar, which technically just came out, but it was kind of a brand relaunch rather than an actual full-on like 1.0. This app used to be called Cron. I made a whole other video about this you can check out up here, wherever. And yeah, all of that still applies. There's one notable change in this one, new feature that I think is really interesting, and depending on how you use Notion as well, could be really useful. So let's go into the settings. And there's a bunch of integrations. We're going to do Notion, and you can go ahead and connect a workspace. So we'll go to connect. We'll be prompted to decide what we want Notion Calendar to have access to in our Notion account. We're going to say allow access. There we go. It kicks me back. And now I'm connected. And you're going to see over here in the sidebar is there's my calendars I have synced, and then there's a line, and then there's any Notion workspaces over here, and a few of the things from my Notion account pulled in here. So these were things I was working on in 2021, 2022, 365 albums was a series I wrote on my blog, and then videos is the one we're going to look at today. And so let's switch over to Notion. So this is the Kanban board I have for this channel. This is the video I'm working on right now, which is in production. Then they go to archive, and then they're completed once I have a personal backup and they're uploaded, all that good stuff. And there's some ideas over here. If we click into this, you can see I have a publish date. So this is only going to show up for boards, databases, whatever, that have dates associated with them, and all my videos have a date. So this is planning to post tomorrow. And I'm actually going to pull this over here so you can kind of see it in real time. So the 27th is when this video is going to go up. So in Notion Calendar, let's hit the I next to this. And hey, there's Notion Calendar showing up tomorrow. Bezel and Apple Podcast Transcripts was released yesterday as of this recording. And you can see that. We could go back further and see other things. But yeah, so here it is. And it's a kind of all-day event because it's just a one-date thing. If I move it to the 28th in Notion Calendar, it's going to update over here in Notion. If I switch it back to the 27th in Notion, it's going to switch back to the 27th in the calendar. You can even do a time. So let's go ahead, clear that out, and let's move it to 10 a.m. Let's say this is actually like a task I'm going to work on. I'm going to work on it for an hour, 10 a.m. to 11 a.m. You can see it updating there. And again, if we remove that, remove the end time, cool, go back, that switches back. So all syncs really nicely, as you'd expect. And of course, if we wanted to check out Bezel and this one, we could open it in Notion. It's going to open in the browser first, unfortunately. But yeah, so here's that one so I can see the page for that video. It's going to vary how useful this is based on how you use Notion. But if you have dates assigned to things, if you use it for task management, or if you use it as some sort of like calendaring system on its own, it could be really nice to bring these in to Notion Calendar. And yeah, that's the only notable thing that's changed, so I wanted to mention it today. I think it is a really good app. I still use Fantastical personally. I think that's just a little better for my needs. The natural language input is particularly good. But yeah, check out the app if you're interested. It's free. It only works with Google accounts, so if you have a Google calendar, you can sync with it. But if you have Outlook, iCloud, you can't. Anyway, watch the Cron video. All that's there. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you here next time. Bye-bye.